Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, welcome to Lakeville. Jack Brody will be your host in the Persian. This is standard battle. It's always important to check your mini-map in these regards. So many times I've been in an encounter battle. Nobody checks the mini-map. And like half or three quarters of the team go here to the valley, which you shouldn't do anyway. It's a choke point for a reason. And yeah, really don't need to be here. In force. I mean, this is looking like too much. The T-34 really shouldn't be here. I mean, I guess he can use his gun depression to great effect. Actually, you know what? 34 is realizing that, and 34 is going the other way. 34 is a very good player and knows what's going on. Oh, hello!
Enemy armor is damaged.
Jack is currently using the regular rounds. But don't be surprised if he switches to gold if we see an actual opponent. They do have a Hummel, and we'd rather not get Hummeled in the face. Oh lord, it's hard to shoot Hummels. They're ugly in every way. Oh, KV-2. Oh, look, our guy's suiciding. That's quaint. Oh, they're all suiciding. That's not good. This is less than ideal. Oh, damn it. That's supposed to be the kill shot. Hey, look, KV-2. Hey, look, our guys are in the way. God, jeez. Whoa! It's at this point that I would let my frustrations get the better of me and just switch right to gold. Because we gotta hold this. Alright, that's good. And you're about to be good. Right in the face, I'm gonna good you up real good. Yeah. There's that Hummel we were talking about. Now, Jack is in a really, really good position here because his turret armor is supremely great. However, his regular round is not good enough, apparently, to go through the mantlet of a very small tank destroyer.
Enemy armor is damaged.
So, as long as he keeps hull down and only exposes his turret armor, he should be good. And the T-20 has less armor than a lot of things, and therefore, easy to do that. The KV-85, how delightful to see you. Hold still, please. Thank you. Plus tinks. I should probably... Ooh, I'm getting a text message. What's going on here? Yep, I am getting a text message. Alright, cool. I am going to get the Pershing at some point. The T-32 and I have come to an understanding. I don't like him. He doesn't like me. But if we cooperate for the good of the team... Oh, hello, Hummel. Oh no, you can just, whatever it is you want to do there, 85, you do that, and I'm just going to shoot the crap out of this Hummel. I can tell that's what's going through Jack's head, other than like a barrel full of whiskey. Awesome, alright, well, we don't have to worry about that shit anymore. And we still have a fair collection of hit points, where he does not, and we may now persecute the enemy. Oh, you bastard. Wow, that thing is... That Fury. Where is he hitting? Where is Jack getting shot? Right in the cheek, lower cheek, and flat-ass upper plate. That is pretty good. Pretty good shooting. And that's why they pay him the medium dollars. I'm not really sure what R34 has been up to, but... hello, 86. Or 46, my bad. It's been a long time since I played the 46. I didn't like it then, and... They do have weird troll front armor. Sometimes you go through, and sometimes... You get a deadly easy shot that bounces. Like, right, this might bounce. It didn't make contact, but it might have bounced. Would you mind coming back here, sir? So yes, the 32 and I have come to a truce, therefore, the Pershing seems like a thing that could be dealt with as well. And it's faster, so... they do come in handy for open league, and I don't have one, so. Oh, hello. See what I'm talking about? Did you see what I am currently speaking about? That troll weird armor? It usually is only good for that, like one good hit and then you're gone. Where's the Pershing? The Pershing was last spotted behind our KV-4 somewhere in the city. Yep, top gun for the Broods. He is a one-man valley-pushing machine. Inferior product should not be endorsed. What is our 34 doing? Is the 34 really trying to sneak? He is actually trying to get back towards our cap. Yeah. GG indeed. Well played, Mr. Broads. Me and Mr. Broads. Oh, hello, Pershing. Delighted to see you, sir. Could you be in some sort of weird... No, okay. That's fine, too. I'm good with that. Zero damage for you. Well, yeah. You kind of... Like, I'd have to watch the replay again, but I'm pretty sure the 34 just kind of hung out near base the entire time, which is really strange because I, you know, he recognized that he should not be in the valley. He wasn't needed. There was a lot of people. So he moved away, and I'm guessing, without looking back on things, that he recognized the fact that a lot of our idiots were suiciding, and he might actually be needed, so he might have come back to help us, and then was too late to do that. So I have to assume that that's what happened. And then the valley, I think there's a coding error or something, but the terrain in the valley is... I'm like 18 times more sticky than anywhere else. Like, you'd probably drive across the bottom of a lake bed faster than you could try driving through that valley. I don't know what it is, but it is quite a thing. So he probably got stuck. In this case, I'm willing to give the guy the benefit of the doubt that he just kind of didn't have, just he yo-yoed around and didn't have the greatest time in the world. Let's look at the final results. Alrighty. First class mastery badge. Top gun. Defender. Not defender. That's not defender. That's duelist. And fire for effect. I appreciate Jack Brody acquiring these screenshots. These are obviously off of the whatreplays.com. I appreciate him doing the extra work to get me the information that I enjoy providing to you. 3,169 damage and 6 kills. Outdone slightly by the KV-4, who apparently had to do battle with the entire universe. And outdone by the Pershing on the enemy team, who had 3,400 damage as well. Wow. The Fury got himself a team kill, so that's fun. I like that. It's handy. The 34 did exactly what he said. He got no damage in. Nothing. Not a zippo zilch. So, it's disappointing, because he's a really good player. However, I think he just tried to do too much without doing anything. I think that's probably the case. So, good play pretty much all around, except for the guys in the valley who just kind of sat around, sitting around, and didn't really accomplish much. Like, pushing the KV-2 through the valley, that's the dumbest thing I've ever seen. That's just stupid. 20, wow, okay, so 20 for 22 shooting, 17 penetrations, damn near 3,200 damage, and 1,030 blocked by armor. And I'm pretty sure this thing has, I want to say 1,250 hit points, something like that. Hits received 13, 6 of them bounced. I think some got ate by the tracks. And we got a little 350 due to assistance there. Nice, nice. 41 cap points, kilometer and a quarter traveled, and ended up with 3,422 XP in the pocket and 30 grand in the bank. So that's what I would call a one-man army. I mean, there's a little assistance here and there, but let's be honest. Jack's a survivor. He survived looking like that his whole life, and also being incredibly short. Probably not accurate details, but funny nonetheless. Enjoy yourselves, and I will see you tomorrow.